Good morning, everyone. I wanted to welcome you to a New Day Church, and let's get ready for some great worship this morning. Melissa has a word that God put on her heart that she wants to share with everyone, so stick around for that. You're going to be blessed. And I know the announcements are coming later, but I'm going to put the plug in early that we have in-person church tonight at 6 p.m. So join us for that and be blessed.
I stand before you now, the greatness of your renown. I've heard of the majesty and wonder of you, King of heaven. In humility I bow. Your love in wave after wave crashes over me, crashes over me.
You are for us, you are not against us, champion of heaven.
Champion of heaven, you made. mountain of heaven, you made a way for all to enter
Hold it! If you're lonely, longing for someone to hear you, if your burdens feel like more than you can bear, if you're searching for a place to just be honest, come just as you are. If you're tired of just hoping for an answer, if you're wishing you could let your guard come down, if you feel like you can't hold it all together, come just as you are. There's no need for any hiding. At the Father's house you met with open arms, and he gives grace without condition. As you are, with nothing else, just come. There is space for everyone who feels unworthy, a place for those who never felt at home, where you don't have to wonder if you're wanted. Come just as you are. There's a hope for you. The one who makes the broken whole again. Now there's no need for you to pick up all the pieces. Hey, come just as you are. Oh, and there's no need for any hiding. And the Father's house, come just as you are.
Cause the God I serve knows only how to triumph. My God will never fail. Oh, my God will never fail. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. Oh, 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 hey. There's power in the mighty name of Jesus. Every war he wages, he wins.
Welcome, everyone. This is a new day, and I want to call you to worship through the giving of your tithes and of your offerings. If you're a faithful giver, thank you. Your tithe goes to the operation of a New Day Church, and your offerings go to missions, the expansion of the kingdom, both locally and throughout the world, which we're actively involved in. But maybe you're not giving of your tithes and offerings. And I want you to consider this, that your tithes and offerings are actually a primary, a basic, a first step in a relationship with Jesus Christ. You might say, well, how is that? Well, there's a scripture in Malachi chapter 3, beginning in verse 7, God is calling with all of his heart to his people. He wants relationship. And so he calls to his people, pleadingly says, come and return to me. And the people just are a little confused, like, well, how should we do that? And it's interesting, God doesn't ask them to pray a prayer. He doesn't ask them to sing a song. He doesn't even ask them to go to church as a first step. He says, return to me through your tithes and your offerings. It's amazing. And the reason why God wants our tithes and our offerings, it would be like saying to God, God, I want you. I love you and I want relationship with you, but I'm not going to give you the treasures in my heart, the primary things, the first things, the important things, which in this case, God knows is your money and your finances. And so today, please consider, do even more than that. Not be just a hearer of the word, but a doer of the word, and make this a new day where you give your tithes, you give your offerings, and there's an open heaven and God's blessing over your life, over your finances, and over everything that you do. God bless you. Again, let's all have a new day together and make Jesus famous.
Question. Have you ever left church and accidentally left Jesus inside? Your daily grind doesn't involve him, but when you're in church, you're full of the Holy Spirit and you're happy and you're able to talk to God freely? Well, I want to share with you a little bit. Join me.
Good morning, a new day. I am so blessed to be here this morning to share with you what God has put on my heart as always. Thank you, Pastor Mark and Carmen, for letting me be here this morning. And as you saw me coming down the stairs, I talked about being close to the Lord and how often it is to fit in those marginal moments when things are perfect. Like when worship is perfect and you're worshiping and everybody around you is in the same place doing the same thing. See, often when we're in our hectic mornings, Monday morning, when it gets here, we don't feel quite like that. We got our work week ahead of us. We got maybe we're caring for somebody. Maybe we have a hectic job. Maybe we have to answer 1,000,000,000 emails, right? Is Jesus the first thing we turn to in those moments? You know, I had to do a hard look at it. I had to look deep into my own life. Am I inviting God into my life and talking to him in every single moment? The reality is Jesus wants to be in every single one of your moments. He wants to be in our lives every second. He wants to know everything we're doing. See, he longs to be part of us. He longs to be part of the good times and the bad. See, he's not looking forward to just all the things that we have going wrong. He's looking forward to the things that are going right, the simple little steps in life. See, he wants to be part of your good and your bad times. In Proverbs 16:3, it talks about committing each day to him. Sorry, I got a little rocks here to work with. The wind's a little windy today, so. Your actions to the Lord and your plans will succeed. See, the writer of Proverbs reminds us, if we commit all we do to the Lord, our plans will be established. See, He wants us to bring our mundane things in our lives to Him. He wants us to recognize that He wants to help us through the simplest things of, like, just taking out the garbage or maybe getting dressed. I mean, it's simple, right? But He wants to be part of all of it, because some things might be a struggle that we don't even realize are gonna be a struggle. See, when we pray that God will give you, when you pray, pray that God will give you what you need rather than what you think you need. He knows our tomorrow. He knows our today. He knows everything. He knows what we're going to need to be ready for the very next day. He gives us what we need, always, always. He always gives us what we need when we need it the most. And let me tell you, I can tell you, when I wake up on Monday morning to go in and brush my teeth, I don't often say, Lord, help me brush my teeth. I don't often say, Lord, help me get dressed. But you know what I do say? Is, Lord, I sat down on my computer and I'm drowning. Okay, I'm here today and I'm drowning. The reality is I can't do this alone. We can't do life alone. And we can't do life one day on a Sunday inside a church. Because, see, God needs more than that. He needs more of us than a Sunday. I don't know how you do your church or when you're with the Lord, but if it's inside a church building, great. If it's online, great. But the thing is we need to have church in His, with Him every day, all day long, in our daily walk. See, in Lamentations 3:22-23 says, because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for His compassion never fails. They are new every morning. Oh my goodness, great is your faithfulness. See, the prophet of Jeremiah in the book of Lamentations, it says it perfectly. We do not have to wait till the morning. See, isn't that great that we can receive God's grace and mercy every day throughout the day? Just because it didn't quite go right in the first few moments doesn't mean we have to wait until Sunday. You don't have to carry all that with you around all week long and then get to church on Sunday and then apologize to the Lord for all of it or ask Him for help for all of it, right? He wants every second of our lives. He wants the ability to be the God He is in everything. He wants to be part of the beginning of every moment that you live. See, nothing's too small or too big for the Lord. He is so able and capable. If you give every moment to Him, He will show up for you. See, if we want to build our lives on a solid rock, This rock, see, is holding down my papers, right? It's this, if we want to build our lives on a solid rock, we have to talk to God daily. And we have to talk to God in every moment. It's easy to forget. But to have a foundation that's stable and endure the hard things that are to come, because let me tell you, people, life is not going to be perfect for nobody. But it's okay, because if we have God fighting our battles for us, every moment, every second, we don't have to worry about it. The hardest times won't be quite as hard. When we least expect it, God will show up and He'll work in the tasks that we have going on in our lives. Simple tasks, doing the dishes. God's gonna show up, I promise you. He will give you the best soap you need. And He will give you hot water, and He will give you what you need, a towel. I'm telling you, it'll be great. You know, I was thinking how simple it is when our dishwasher breaks to find the joy in a broken dishwasher, right? The joy of it is that we get to get our hands wet, we can turn on some worship music, and we can spend an extra 15 minutes with the Lord instead. Isn't that great? Isn't it wonderful that he's going to provide for all of us, for everything? See, the key is communication. What is your communication like? Is your communication on Sundays? Just on Sundays? Or is your communication every moment when your feet first hit the floor in the morning? Communication is the desire of your heart and your heart wanting to trust God. You know, the beautiful thing about being within amongst a church family is feeling God's love, right? And feeling that. Well, we need to take that outside of Sunday, right? We need to love on people outside of Sunday. We need to have more Jesus outside of Sundays. Our thoughts and our motives are really nothing, actually, without being grounded in Him. Are you grounded in Christ? Are you trusting Him for every single thing in your life? Are you trusting Him to guide your path for Monday morning when you first open your eyes? Are you believing and trusting that His way is the best way? See, I have a friend. Her name is Sandra. She's battling terrible cancer. Okay? She had to go out on a limb. She had to trust that every single moment God would take care of her, because she went on a cruise and she stepped out of her comfort zone at home where she felt better because she could lie down and she could take her medication on time and she could do all that she needed to do to feel good enough to make it to the next day. But you know what? Instead, people, she trusted God to show up in every single second of that cruise. And let me tell you, it was sustainable. It was amazing. God took her from the beginning and to the end. She had the best time. Her heart was filled with joy. She was surrounded by happiness. She smiled the entire time she was there. There wasn't a moment that she was like, oh, well, I don't know if I can do this. And no, she said, God, help me do this. Help me today, help me tomorrow. See, and that's what God wants from us. If she didn't trust in Him, it wouldn't have gone quite so well. Perhaps she would have went and she would have needed to stay in her cabin or whatever they call it. But instead, she believed and she stayed strong in the Lord. See, God wants to pick us up when we stumble. He wants to take us and help us build our life on rocks as a foundation with Him. Not on slippery sand. Trust me, people. You don't want to be in sand. It's really hard to walk in. It's terribly hot when the sun's beating on it. You want to be on some solid, firm foundation. See, our lives can get freedom in Christ. And we can't let ourselves get caught up in this daily grind without letting the Lord guide our footsteps. Don't forget about God. Don't just remember Him on Sundays. I often need to remind myself of all the things that I have going on in my week from Monday to Sunday. You know, I need to start asking God myself for those daily decisions, for that moment-to-moment decisions that I'm going through, to be living in me every second. And even when things get to the point where we just don't want it anymore, because trust me, I can tell you, just this week, I didn't want it anymore, okay? I wanted to tap out. But you know what I did do? I forgot. I forgot to dig deep in the Lord, okay? It wasn't till last night at Bible study that I realized I needed to find joy. Joy in those situations that are really tough. And find joy in everything. You know, that's hard, right? That is really hard. But you know what? If you have God in your every moment, He will bring joy to your soul, peace to your mind, love to your heart, and strength to your body. I can promise you that. Because He showed up for me, okay? I can tell you that God's grace showed up for me. So, in 2 Corinthians 12:9, it says. But he answered me, my grace is always more than enough for you, and my prayer finds its full expression through your weakness. So I will celebrate my weakness, for when I am weak, I sense more deeply the mighty power of Christ living in me. See, Christ is gonna, he's gonna flourish in you. During the hardest times of times, God's gonna show up bigger. I can promise you this. And if you trust in him to guide you, you will live on. You will live on powerful and strong in him. So, how are you planning on getting through the grind of life? Daily with Jesus, or just on church days? Paul tells us specifically in 1 Thessalonians 5:16 through 18, rejoice always, pray without ceasing, and everything give thanks. This is the will of God in Christ Jesus. See, he gives us the tools right there. He gives us the tools. If we pray and we rejoice in the Lord always, he will show up and he will help us. So if you find yourself falling into a really bad place, you're slipping away from God, you're on some sand, some really bad sand, well, all you got to do is start talking to him. It starts with a conversation. It starts with more than showing up to church and going through motions, okay? He's your best friend. He's the only one who's going to help you battle your week. He's the only one who will always be there, no matter how you feel, what you're doing, how terrible you are. Because you know what? We probably forget about God a lot, right? Sometimes it's not our first thought. Sometimes for some of us it is. I'm not gonna say that that's not true for all, but for a lot of us, we're grinding. We're going through the day and we're like, wait a minute, have I talked to God today? So, trust in him, talk to him, get close to him. Rely on him for everything. Not just to fill you up once a week, because our souls need more than once a week, okay? So, it's called preventative care, right? We prevent things from happening. We go to the doctor once a year for preventative care so they can make sure there's not something crazy going on in there, right? So, that's the same thing with God. If we do preventative care, we talk to him on a daily basis, we get in the Word of God, and we read, he will help us always. I can promise you, he is an amazing God, and he loves all of you. So, if you're interested in knowing this God, if you don't know him and you're watching for the first time, boy, now's the time. Now's the time for you to connect and have a relationship with Jesus Christ, your Savior. And you know what? You can join us on Sundays, and then you can join us every day, because every day is a day of the Lord. All right, family, I love you. That's what I got for you today. We will see you again soon. Bye now. That was a fantastic message, Melissa. We can learn so much from that. It's so true. When we're in church and we're with God's people and we're engaged in worship and we have our little comfortable surroundings, we can, you know, just be with God and trust him, and we can overcome anything. And then we step out of church and Monday morning comes, and then the obstacles come. We're in traffic. We have plans for something and the weather's just terrible. You know, the unexpected bill, all the things in life that happen, and we put Jesus on a shelf and we set him aside, and we don't go to that source that activates us into having that relationship with God. And today I thought was a perfect example. I usually research the weather all week for Melissa and my big hike on Saturday, and we get so excited, you know, what mountain can we climb, where can we go? And as you know, April's been terrible. The weather's been terrible in April, and we have been struggling to find good weather. And I looked for this Saturday. I looked east, west, south, north, rain everywhere. And I just felt in my heart, let's go to Kamano Island. Let's make the best of it. So I looked this morning, and the weather was still terrible. But you know what?
Melissa and I decided to carry that small mustard seed of faith and say, we're going to step out of our comfort zone, our warm, cozy beds. We're going to get all our hiking gear. We're going to put those backpacks on, and we are going to trust God that He's in control of the weather and can give us good weather. And as you can see, I am on Kamano Island at Kama Beach State Park, and the Lord gave us sunshine. Not only did He not give us the rain that was supposed to come, He gave us sunshine. So I hope this builds your faith, because I know it has built our faith. God bless.
Melissa, thank you. That was a fantastic word, very much needed today. Hey everybody, Tom Gerges, all the way from the great state of North Carolina. And I get to do the announcements. How blessed is this? Unbelievable. Well, first of all, let's start off with every Tuesday night. Every Tuesday night, I know Sandra and Melissa are doing a Bible study, and it is called Take Back Your Life. That's 7 p.m. And by the way, if you're online and you think you can't be in part of that, you're wrong. We can get you in. They have software. You can just be blocked right in like a Zoom call. I guess it's awesome. So contact Sandra and Melissa if you want to be part of that. And I think you really do. On Wednesday nights, it's the fastest 15 minutes of prayer around. I know that 15 minutes is a stretch, so we're not going to say any more other than it's at 7 p.m. On Pacific Standard Time, and of course, 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for us late owls. But that could be changing too. You never know. We might start up some prayer out here out this way too, so be looking for that. Thursdays are, well, every other Thursday or so, something like that, is going to be, we're going to do TNT TV again. So we're going to try to get that rolling again. So be looking online. Check out our website. Everybody push to the website, okay? If you can, for TNT TV and all the different announcements that are going on. Geez. Next Sunday will be, of course, our church services online, YouTube, 10 a.m., 1 p.m. our time out here in North Carolina. But I'm not sure who's teaching. Oh, do we know who's teaching? That handsome, debonair? It's me. I don't know. It's me. I'm teaching, I think it's the 22nd, so I think that's my time in the hopper. So be looking for that. That'll be a great word, something God has put on my heart, and I think you'll find it special. July 17th is Join Us for Faith in the Fields. Now, this is going to be a big shindig. Tickets are available. Check out the website for this, please. We want as many bodies up there as we can. There's going to be dinner. There's going to be worship. This is going to be an awesome time, and all the proceeds, gang, go to Daniel Yaden's medical bills. This is, I can't stress this enough. This is a huge help, and we really want to do this. So God bless you guys. I hope you have a fantastic Sunday. Thanks for hanging in there with the announcements, and I'll talk to you soon. Thanks.